everyone, Christina Werner here. Welcome to another video for Simus a Stamp. Today I'm looking at the June 2020 card kit, and I'm going to be creating three different cards using the supplies from the kit. Starting out with the stencil, and I'm going to be doing some ink blending using the pattern paper in the kit as color inspiration. I'm going to be using five different colors of Distress Oxide inks today. And when I do this first one, I'm not going to be using peeled paint. I decided to not use the green on this first card, but on the later cards, I do use that color. So I first taped down some white cardstock to a slick surface. This is a Tonic Easy Clean Matte. And I've taped down the cardstock, and then I've taped my stencil on top as well. And for those corners that were exposed, because I tilted the stencil, I just covered those with some post-it tape. I then took some blender brushes from Honey Bee, and I blended on scattered straw, followed by abandoned coral distress oxide inks. And I want to get those blended kind of up in that top corner. I then brought in some festive berries. This will intensify that coral shade. And for the last color, I'm going to be bringing in some seedless preserves. And seedless preserves is a color that's not really in the pattern papers, but I wanted just a little bit of a more intense shade, just one step more than that festive berries. And I thought that seedless preserves would look really pretty. So I did that initial blending, and now I'm going to remove some of the corner pieces, and I'm going to go over each area and kind of just do a really faint blending. I kind of want to have this blown out effect, almost like the color of the butterflies is glowing. So I'm going over those same areas with the exact colors I used before. So after I had all of that blending done, just really soft blending, and these blender brushes are perfect for really soft blending like this, then I took a spray bottle and I just sprayed some water in the palm of my hand and sprinkled it down onto my card. And I'm doing this because Distress Oxide inks, just like the original Distress inks, they reactivate with water. So you can get some really fun effects when you add water to any dry Distress Oxide ink. Gives it a little bit of an oxidation, kind of almost bleaches the color. It looks really, really neat. I then washed my stencil really well and then placed it back over the top. I'm now going to be using the Glitz glitter gel that's included in the kit, and I'm just spreading that over these butterflies. And this is an iridescent Glitz glitter gel. It's more transparent, and so the colors underneath will show through. So that's what's really cool about this particular kind of glitter embossing paste or glitter gel. You can use whatever color underneath and then put the glitter on top, and it looks like you've used multiple colors of glitter. Do want to caution you, you don't want to put that leftover Glitz glitter gel back in the jar when you put it over top of inks, because that glitter gel can really pick up the color underneath. So I removed the stencil, and I'm going to let this dry. I let it completely dry. It took about maybe about 20-30 minutes. It probably dried faster than that, but I didn't notice because I had moved on and worked on other things. But then I grabbed the friend stamp, the greeting stamp from the stamp set in the kit for June, and I stamped that in some VersaFine Onyx Black ink. It's just going to nestle in there right in the middle of these butterflies, and it's going to just have that little greeting right there in the center. I then trimmed it down just a little bit so that it's 4 inches wide by 5 1/4 tall. This is going to give me just a little bit of a border on my actual card base, which is made out of some Nina Classic Crest Solar White cardstock. I just scored that at 5.5 to create a top folding card. I then applied some foam adhesive on the back of my ink blended piece and then adhered that to the card base. And that finishes my first card. I'm going to move on to cards 2 and 3, and both of these use watercolor paper. I'm using some Arches watercolor paper today, and I already had a piece cut, so I'll just use that. I'm going to be stamping all of the butterflies from the Beautiful Butterfly stamp set in the kit, and I've placed them all on my watercolor panel. I'm going to stamp these all at the same time using some VersaFine Onyx Black ink. And because this is a really big area to stamp, and also because the paper is very textured, I'm going to stamp all of these butterflies twice. That's why using a stamp positioning tool like the Misti is great for instances like this, because it gives you the opportunity to stamp images multiple times with ease and without a lot of error. So I stamped that twice. Then I cleaned off a couple of those stamps and moved my paper to the top of my Misti and then stamped two more butterflies at the bottom just to kind of fill out that pattern. I'm going to be doing some watercoloring with those same distress inks. So I've taped down my pattern that I've stamped to a hard board and I'm putting on water. I'm just doing a nice layer of water all across this paper. And I've also smushed four of my ink colors. I've got Seedless Preserves, Festive Berries, Scattered Straw, and Peeled Paint. And I'm going to be picking those up with a large round brush and a little bit of water and just bring them over to my butterfly stamped pattern. And I want to have a really colorful panel for this. The Peeled Paint green shade really does add a lot to this kind of mixture of color. I want all these colors to blend with each other. After those initial colors were applied, I hit that with my heat tool just to make sure I had a nice layer of color. I then added some additional color on top, let some of the harsher lines from the water kind of create some interest, and add a lot of color in trying to get some layers of color. At this point, I decided that I wanted to add some additional water droplets or paint splatter. So I did that with a couple of different colors. I started with the Festive Berries, and I just put that on the edge of an acrylic block and then splattered that down onto my butterfly panel. I then grabbed some more Seedless Preserves because I thought it needed some darker splatters. And when I was trying to get this to splatter, I dropped my paintbrush. You can see those blobs there. But I just used the same paintbrush and kind of spread that color out, and it worked out great to disguise my little blooper there. Like I did on the very first card, I let that panel dry, and then I spritzed some water in the palm of my hand and added that water to my project. And this just lifts some of the color, and it gives more variation in all of the different colors. So that's a finished panel for my card. I cut it down so it's a little bit smaller than an A2 card and then created my card base out of that same white cardstock. Put some foam adhesive on the back and then adhered that to my card front. Now's the time to do my greeting for this card. And I'm using the circular stamp from the Beautiful Butterfly stamp set that says Long Distance Hug. That would be perfect for this card. And I'm just stamping that in the same VersaFine Onyx Black ink. It's a nice, really stark black ink. And I used my scissors to trim this circle greeting out. Of course, if you have a circle die that's of a similar size, you could use that through your die cutting machine. But I just fussy cut this with some scissors. Put some foam adhesive on the back, and then adhered that directly to my card. So that's card number two, all complete. I'm going to move on to the third and final card. Cutting down some of that Arches cold press watercolor paper to 3.5 by 5.5. This watercolor paper is going to go eventually onto a 5 by 7 card. So that's why I picked that particular dimension for this watercolor paper. And for whatever reason, I decided to not tape this watercolor paper down to a hard board. I usually do. I'm not sure why. I think maybe I just wanted to test it out and see if I really do need to tape it down every time. And I do. I really should have taped this down, but I didn't. I did a nice wash of water and then brought in some scattered straw and abandoned coral. I'm using really, really faint colors for this because I want a really soft watercolor background. I made sure that I didn't have any harsh edges of color, and I really wanted those edges to kind of fade to white. After that was completely dry, I stamped the largest butterfly from the Beautiful Butterfly stamp set. And like I stamped before, I did do multiple stamps of this so that I got a really solid image and a really, really dark black. After one stamp, you can see it doesn't fill in all those gaps, but after the second stamp, the impression looks awesome. So I put some foam adhesive on the back of that watercolor panel and then put it directly onto the front of a 5x7 card base. So that's just going to pop up that watercolor piece. For the greeting for this card, I'm going to use some black cardstock. This is just a scrap of black cardstock I had on hand. I'm not entirely sure where it's from, but I'll link to some black cardstock in the supplies if you're looking for some good black cardstock. I used an anti-static powder tool to prep the area before stamping, since I will be doing some embossing. And then I inked up that stamp with VersaMark ink. VersaMark ink is a clear, sticky ink that's perfect for embossing. I applied some gilded embossing powder from British Monroe. It's a nice gold embossing powder. And then heat set that until it was smooth and melted. Then used my scissors to trim out this greeting and adhered it right over the center of that large butterfly using some foam tape. So just use my tweezers to get that in the right spot. So that finishes the third card. There are so many things that you can do with this card kit. I didn't even break out the pattern paper or some of the other supplies that are in the kit. There's so much you can do. Make sure you check out the links in the video description to go over to the Symasys Stamp store and pick up your own card kit. Thanks for watching, and I will catch you guys in another video very soon.